Welcome to Doggo.jl, your home for wholesome Julia tutorials. Until now, all of the code that you've seen is from Julia Base, which provides many useful functions that you may need on a day-to-day basis. But Julia also comes included with a standard library, which provides many more useful functions, but ones that you may not need on a regular basis. In its most basic form, a library is just a collection of functions that someone else has already written and optimized, so you can just reuse their code without having to reinvent the wheel. In the Julia documentation, you can find a list of the standard libraries. I'll be honest, I haven't used all of these libraries, but I'm going to show you how to use a couple of the libraries that I use frequently. The Random Numbers library and the Statistics library. Let's start by taking a look at the Random Numbers library. I'm in VS Code where I've already created a new .jl file. I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. In addition, I've docked my REPL window next to my editor. In Julia Base, there's a function named rand, which generates random numbers between 0 and 1 inclusive, using a uniform distribution. If you use an integer as the argument, the rand function will return that amount of random numbers contained in a vector. Because these numbers were generated randomly, these numbers will be different every time. And my numbers will be different than your numbers. But sometimes you want to be able to recreate these so-called random numbers. So how can you recreate random numbers if they're generated randomly? Well, it turns out that computer-generated random numbers are not actually random. They just appear to be random. You can recreate these so-called random numbers if you know the random seed that was used to create them in the first place. In Julia, the random seed function can be found in the Random Numbers library. To access any of Julia's standard libraries, type in the keyword using, followed by the name of the library. The name of the library will begin with an uppercase letter. In this case, the name of the library is random, starting with an uppercase R. This code makes the functions contained in the random library available for you to use. The function that we need is named seedBank, and you can call it by using this dot notation. For the function argument, you can use any integer, but if you use the same number that I'm using, you should get the same result as me. I'm going to clear my REPL display by clicking on the REPL tab, and then hitting Ctrl-L. And then, I'm going to hit Shift-Enter in the editor. In the REPL, you'll see a new vector with 10 new random numbers. But the difference is that you should see the same 10 numbers on your computer. So that's pretty useful. Another useful library is the statistics library. So let's take a look at that next. Let's start by generating a vector containing 1,000 random numbers using a normal distribution by using the randn function as opposed to the rand function. A normal distribution is a distribution with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. To calculate the average value of the numbers in this vector, you can declare and define your own custom function. And then you can call your function. But a more convenient way to solve this problem is to use the functions that come included with the statistics library. The statistics library provides a function named mean, which calculates the average value in a collection. Note that this value is the same as the value that you calculated using your own custom function, but you didn't need to declare and define a new function. All you had to do was reuse someone else's function that's already been optimized for Julia. The statistics library also comes included with many other functions that are common to the statistics domain, like median and standard deviation. So this dataset has a mean value and a median value that's pretty close to 0. And a standard deviation that's pretty close to 1, which are characteristics of a normal distribution. You can find a list of all of the functions available in any of these standard libraries in the Julia documentation. So that's the basics of using Julia's standard library. In the next chapter, you'll learn how to use external packages in Julia.